These were the times in our lives when we were young and full of hope. These were the times when we were separated from our families and had to fend for ourselves and do chores like keeping our cabinets clean, make up our own beds, and manage our finances. These were the days when we buried ourselves in our books countless nights in study, writing papers, and endlessly talking about schoolwork and life in general. These were some of the best days of our lives. The Ateneo De Manila has been a bastion for progressive learning since it was founded by the Society of Jesus in the mid-19th century. As the Philippines began to grow in stature in the world community, there was an influx of the best minds from all over the country into the capital of Manila.
I think if you look at the history of the Ateneo, most of the students were actually dormers. If we think about, you know, during results time.
And the school built dormitories, first in Intramuros, then in Padre Faura, and eventually in Loyola Heights, where Loyola Center, today's Blue Eagle Gym, and Bellarmine Hall once served as a residence quarters. Soon after that, the Cervini and Eliaza residences were put up to house a growing population who come to avail of the Ateneo's excellent education.
I was a bit overwhelmed because I came from the former Ateneo de San Pablo in 1973, and I came from a small city, a small school of about 600 students, and then suddenly I'm inside the Ateneo campus.
I remember they were from Ilocos, and one was from the Visayas, from Negros. So they were talking in tongues from different dialects, and I had a hard time adjusting initially. But after a while, you get to understand, you get to appreciate the different cultures, the different dialects, and that makes me a more sympathetic, a better person.
Kaya ako nag-Ateneo because of two factors. One is yun nga, it is a Catholic university. And then, second, because of the course. Parang Ateneo kasi kilala siya for the course management engineering. Also, may scholarship kasi ako dito sa school.
Many of my teammates at that time, Ateneo yung back-to-back champions, were all from Manila also. But staying in the dorm was very convenient at that time because you just walk to practice, come back in the dorm. It was like your home.
The dorms were more than the students' living quarters. In many ways, they were an extension of the classroom where one had to learn life's real lessons. Father Alberto Ampil once said that the dorm was a huge help in one's maturation process, for it forced them to confront the realities of living alone and making the most out of their time.
I cherish the freedom not to really to do what I wanted, to be responsible for my life, to take care of my schedule. And it was a very exciting phase in my life dahil iba't ibang mga kaibigan, iba't ibang interest. So meron akong barkada sa Glee Club, may barkada of course ako sa dorm, may barkada din akong mga Ilonggo, at may barkada akong mahilig sa pekwa at saka sa inuman.
You mentioned about maturity. Being by yourself puts in a lot of responsibilities.
Dorm life was great because you could always have somebody who's in the same class with you, working with you, sharing notes.
So with your roommates, you can always talk with them and talk about your dreams, about your previous women in the campus.
Well, I don't fix my bed at home, but now I'm very OC about my bed. I actually used to list down all the expenses for 1 month. And they're like, oh, I saved like out of my 7,000 allowance, I spent 4 or 5. Oh, cool, I have 2 or 5.
The great thing about having roommates is that they always nag you about it. They say, Karen, ano to? Ba't nandito na naman yung hamper mo? Ba't nandito yung books mo? Ganun, ganun.
Of course, schooling and dorm life wasn't all books and exams. There were a number of events, staples of dorm life, that complemented and enriched their lives and made for timeless memories.
Even when Eliaso was first built, it was really meant only for male students. Okay. So we didn't have much of a social life then with inside campus, but we made sure that we'd have a lot of activities with the dormers of the other schools.
Kasi open house kasi people fake their rooms. Every open house the night before people clean their wings, clean their rooms, and give the impression to the outsiders. Ganito pala kalinis yung dorm, grabe, cool.
Siguro activities sa dorm na personal na gustong-gusto ko talaga, yung mga parang weekend movie, ano namin, movie gatherings ng mga friends ko sa dorm. Parang lahat kami magsistay sa isang room din, manamad kami ng movie, magpuyatan kami ng umaga.
So what was funny is kami as players, always active kami, so we could not even keep the rooms clean. So you'd find the supporters at that time, jockstrap, whatever you call that, socks and wet jerseys hanging all over the room, no? Namin, dahil apat kayo to a room, eh. So ang iba nakahang sa electric fan para matuyo. And then here comes these girls, you invite them, show them the room, and then they'd see it's all a typical boys' room. So that was really fun.
There's always the question and answer while you are still in the basement where you talk about things. And there will always be the question of who is the hottest Ruvinian, who's your upper class crush. There was a lot of crying during RSM because it was a time when we could let out our homesickness, our feelings of separation from loved ones, family and significant others. But the greatest thing about that was how everybody just gave a group hug.
In the dorm allowed me at that time to make decisions for myself, take responsibility for my decisions. When I'm going to study, when I'm going to go out to play basketball.
There is a bond among dormmates. When I go out, I go to different provinces, and if you get to meet someone who is from Cervini, you may not belong to the same batch, but there is a certain affinity, a certain identification that makes you closer.
You're a composite of all your experience, and each experience only enriches your whole being. Part of being in the dorm made you closer to your classmates, made you appreciate your sense of self because you were living with three other guys.
Their Ateneo education made more enriching by school community life, dormers have gone out into the world and spread their wings, making significant contributions in various industries and nation building. But they've never forgotten their roots, when those years when their dorm life helped in their formation.
The work now of nation building, of uniting our people from different regions, nag-ugat yan sa panahon ko sa dorm. Na kasama ko hindi lamang yung mga Ilonggo, kundi kasama ko rin yung mga taga Davao, taga Cebu, taga Bicol, taga San Pablo, mga Kapampangan, mga Tagalog. We saw the good in each other. There was genuine solidarity in the dorm. We brought out the best in one another. We had great fun. We were truly one people. At the root of our poverty, the fact that we are a divided people, no, by divided by regionalism, they're divided by religion, and partisan interest.
And now a new dorm is rising above the old ones we used to call home. A 150-room twin tower dorm, right where the old swimming pool used to be and still overlooking the Marikina Valley below, will open its doors to upperclassmen. The old Cervini and Eliazo halls will be the initial homes of incoming freshmen as well as masteral and exchange students.
And every dormer, whether you're from Cervini or from Ilyaso, you ought, you're obligated to come home and help.
It is here where a whole new generation of Ateneans eager to plunge into that famous Jesuit education will dream, hatch goals and ambitions, partake in the glories of young adulthood, and grow into productive citizens of the Philippines and of the world. And the Ateneo Dorms, their home away from home, will be a repository of good memories and happy times, and perhaps more importantly, an extension of their Ateneo education. These were the times when we as dormers found community with one another, as we discovered who we are and how we could be the best we could possibly be. These were the times when we grew up to be a man and woman not just for others, but for the world. These were some of the best days of our lives.